I am a Wilmington University mentee. My mentor is Reverend Dr. Zenobia A. James. I call her Dr. Z. Dr. Z and I consistently spoke at least once a week via Skype or Uvu. As fate would have it, I was initially technologically challenged when I entered into the mentoring program. My laptop and desktop both caught a virus. I got the viruses wiped out and upgraded my laptop to Windows 8.1 Pro. Then I spent about 2 weeks learning how to maneuver the programs and making sure all external parts, like the camera and printers, were compatible. Windows 8.1 requires internet access for everything, even access to Microsoft Word. Dr. Z and I were tasked with a community service project to accomplish during the year. The Leukemia and Lymphoma Society of Delaware, which I will call LLS, was the nonprofit organization that we were partnered with. The mission of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society is to cure leukemia, lymphoma, Hodgkin's disease, and myeloma, and to improve the quality of life for their patients and their families. The project for LLS consisted of attending in-person school visits to kick off school-wide assemblies. As a mentee, although I was given literature explaining what takes place during an assembly, I am a visual person. I needed to observe an assembly. I felt it was best for me to see what an actual kickoff assembly looked like. Since the assemblies did not kick off yet, I asked Jessica, the campaign manager of the school and youth programs for LLS, to meet with me and show me what an assembly entailed. Every month, I sent a monthly update to Lauren. Dr. Z sent a quarterly update to Lauren. Due to this year's extreme winter weather, there were many school cancellations. My first kickoff assembly was at Brandywine Community School on February 10, 2014. My heart felt full as Jessica read a poem that was found by a parent of a child that lost a battle with this blood disease. I saw firsthand how the work of the LLS impacts our youths. Words cannot fully express the feeling that I had when the students interacted and asked questions about the campaign. Jessica and I encountered a student and a teacher who had family members that were dealing with these illnesses. Compassion, dedication, and tolerance are just a few of the attributes that LLS puts into these programs. My second school assembly was at Claymont Elementary School on April 7, 2014. I had an interactive object lesson to illustrate what blood cancer is and how it affects the body. I concluded with ways in which students can help make a difference. There was props, which consisted of a cape, a red blood cell poster, a white blood cell poster, a platelet poster, and two cancer cell posters. I asked the students if they understood what blood cancer was. To help them understand what blood cancer was, I explained to them that there are different parts inside of their blood, inside of my blood, inside of everyone's blood. There are three parts: white blood cells, red blood cells, and platelets. I asked for a volunteer, chose a volunteer, and they became the white blood cell. I had that student stand in front, and I asked the school audience to introduce themselves to the Wendy white blood cell. I asked Wendy, the white blood cell, to say hello to everyone. I explained that Wendy, the white blood cell, helps fight off germs and keeps the body healthy. I gave them an example and said Let's say you were sitting in class, or maybe you were sitting in the movie theater, and the person next to you keeps coughing. You might think, uh-oh, I am going to catch their cold. Well, Wendy, the white blood cell fights off those germs and keeps your body healthy. I asked if I could have another student come up front and play Ryan, the red blood cell. I selected a student. I basically asked the student to say hello to the audience and the audience to say hello to Ryan, the red blood cell. I explained to the boys and girls that the second part of the blood is the red blood cell. I stated that Ryan was here to help us understand what a red blood cell does. I asked the audience on the count of three if they could take a deep breath. I asked Ryan to count to three for me, and at the count of three, everyone was to take a deep breath. When they were done, I said that that was well done. And I explained that all of us just breathed in air. We breathed in oxygen. Red blood cells grabs that oxygen and carries it throughout the body, from our head down to our toes. So Ryan, the red blood cell, carries oxygen and gives our body energy. I explained to the audience that we were now going to talk about the last part of the blood. I asked for my final volunteer to be Paulie the platelet. I selected that student, and that student said hello to the audience, and then the audience said hello to Paulie the platelet. I asked Paulie the platelet to please wave to all his fans. I told the students that we were going to pretend that we were on a playground. I told them that if they fell and cut their knee and started to bleed a little bit, Paulie the platelet goes around the cut and stops all the bleeding, basically forming a clot. So, the clot is stopping the bleeding. That's how a scab is formed. These three cells makes up everyone's blood. Wendy, the white blood cell, and all the white blood cells fight germs. Ryan, the red blood cell, and all the red blood cells carries oxygen. And Paulie, the platelet, and all the platelets clot blood. And those are all the three parts of your blood. For people with leukemia, their blood looks very different. One of their healthy white cells changes and turns into a cancer cell. That one cell grows and multiplies into these cancer cells, and the cancer cell starts to take over the blood and crowd our healthy cells. We've had our three volunteers for the blood cells. Now I'm going to ask the audience to, if they wanted to participate, basically, and I would get two more volunteers to represent cancer cells, excuse me. I selected the two volunteers and I handed them the cancer cell posters. I also would have them stand in the front. And basically, I would ask the cancer cells to stand in front of those three blood cells. Remember, it was the white blood cells, the red blood cells, and the platelets. So basically, these two blood cells, cancer blood cells, was standing in front of the healthy blood cells. So basically, this is what happens in the bodies. The bad cancer cells blocks the healthy blood cells. And then I would ask to have one more volunteer, and that volunteer would be Captain Chemo. The volunteer would come up front, and they would be Captain Chemo to the rescue. Chemo is the medicine that a person with leukemia might take. So Captain Chemo would take away the cancer cells. Basically, he would go in front of those cancer cells and knock them out the way. So basically, Captain Chemo saved the day. And in children's language, that's basically how the chemo works in the body, fighting the cancer cells and restoring those healthy cells. Assembly was at Pleasantville Elementary School on April 14, 2014. This assembly was to consist of a Charlie Brown DVD, which explains how leukemia works in the body. Unfortunately, the students did not watch the DVD because the DVD would not cooperate. This did not turn out to be a problem because the school had an awards assembly, which took up most of the time anyway. I went on to basically explain the Pasta for Pennies program and indicated that it will be running in their school for the next 3 weeks. I made the students aware of the incentives and indicated that the highest fundraising class would win a lunch from Olive Garden. I explained to the students that blood was really important in their body. The students agreed. I explained that leukemia was a blood cancer in the blood. And then I basically explained to everyone that they were going to receive their very own coin box. I showed them the coin boxes and explained that they were going to take them home and bring them back with all of their coins. I asked the students if any.
Congratulations to Yvonne Poole for completing her MBA and for being a good mentee. She was very energetic. She was very competent. She was persevering because we did run into many challenges. And today we can say that we were granted success in being a part of the mentoring network and for the project with the school and youth for LSS. I, Dr. Z, would like to thank Wilmington University for giving Yvonne and I opportunity to participate in this pilot program network, mentoring networking, and also the Leukemia Lymphoma Society for allowing us to be volunteers and participating in the project of raising funds for cancer patients. Again, we say thank you. We were an extraordinary team. And we have our own penny boxes with our personal donations. Again, thank you. Pennies for patience. Today is today. You can help the Cancer Leukemia Lymphoma Society with your Pennies for Patients. You can donate online, lls.org. Small or large will be appreciated, and you will help many people. Children who suffer with leukemia more than adults, and they start very young. Again, we thank you for giving us this opportunity.